Now, there are guys that are in the middle or third stage. They're not really in the middle. They're the best combination of both. And that's the guy you really want to be. That's the guy that she really wants to date. She wants to date a guy that has the best traits of the nice guy. He's nice, and he can also set boundaries. He's nice when he wants to be, and he can say no when he wants to. So in this video, I'd like to talk about why women get attracted to bad boys and nice guys and why they go back and forth a lot. This is something that you guys really need to understand. And when you think about that, the bad boy I'm referring to is on the extreme end of the bad boy. Typically the player, bad boy, I don't give a fuck. And then the nice guy, nice to a fault. Not that it's bad to be nice, he's just nice to a fault. Like, he cannot stand up for himself. He has no boundaries. He gets all his validation from making women and other people and his friends happy. So he's constantly trying to figure out what you want, to give you what you want, so he feels secure and safe. So why do women get drawn to bad boys in the first place? Well, bad boys are typically good with attention. They're not afraid of it. They're not afraid to say, you know what, I want to bend you over. They're not afraid to be sexually attracted to her. They're not afraid to be dirty, naughty, raunchy. They're not afraid to step into tension with her. And that's sexy, because that's a man that's confident. That's a man that'll go for it. That's a man that'll take risks. If he says, I like you, she feels it inside. She's like, wow, I know he means it, because he's congruent, because he's not afraid of saying that. If he says, I'm turned on by you, he means it. If he says you got a sexy ass and legs, he means it. She can feel the congruency in that. And he's not afraid to tell her what he wants in the bedroom and to encourage her to express herself in the bedroom to a degree too. And this sets her free in a lot of ways. Now, what happens with that? Well, the bad boy, oftentimes, if he's a true bad boy, also is not afraid to hurt her, is not afraid to go find other women, is not afraid to say, you know what, you pissed me off today, I'm gonna go fuck this other girl. And that's part of what's wrong with the bad boy for the girl. So a lot of women, they fall in love with the bad boy because he's not afraid of tension, he steps into it, he expresses emotion, he expresses feeling, but then they get their heart broken by the bad boy too. They get hurt by the bad boy because he takes off on them, he dumps them, he moves on. And when they're hurt and when they're sad or when they're lonely inside after being hurt by the bad boy, a lot of times they choose the nice guy. He's safe. You know what? He's not gonna hurt me. You know what? He's gonna tell me exactly what I wanna hear for a while. He's gonna make me feel good. And she may not even know she's doing this. And he's a nice, safe place for her to be while she goes through this, possibly through a transition. She might reach a point in her life where she wants to go for a long period of not dating any more bad boys, and she just wants a nice guy. A nice guy. And she's with him maybe for a year, 2 years. Maybe she has a child with him. And at a certain point, she starts to get bored, complacent. There's no tension. He's not stepping into tension with her anymore. And she starts to dream of that bad boy again. And she's bouncing back and forth between the two, this nice guy and this bad boy, because these are the bulk of her two choices in the world today. Now, there are guys that are in the middle or third stage. They're not really in the middle. They're the best combination of both. And that's the guy you really want to be. That's the guy that she really wants to date. She wants to date a guy that has the best traits of the nice guy. He's nice, and he can also set boundaries. He's nice when he wants to be, and he can say no when he wants to. He can look at her and say, I can bend you over, but he so believes in himself and integrity that he's also honest, and he says, if I'm gonna be your boyfriend, he's gonna be your boyfriend. He's not gonna lie to her or cheat on her. If he's gonna be single, he's gonna be really honest with her. I'm gonna be single, and I'm not committing to you right now. He's not gonna tell her what she wants to hear. He's gonna tell her what she needs to hear, what the moment wants her to say, so that he can be the best version of himself. He's concerned with being a solid, powerful man, not to please her, but because he wants to be the most confident version of himself. And so when a guy that's in this place chooses a woman, he chooses her from a place of power and choice. I want to be with a woman. I want to be in a relationship, not just because I'm afraid of losing you, but because that's what I want. And that's the type of man we need more of out there. He's the best of the nice guy, best of the bad boy. And he's powerful, and he's confident, and he's real. And I promise you that each one of you can be that. You see, the beautiful thing about the nice guy is the nice guy is learning to feel. He's scared to say no, but he's learning to feel. He's feeling everybody because he's trying to read their emotions to be the best for them. And when he drops all that fear of saying no and setting boundaries, he actually starts to move to this third stage guy, this guy that's real, because he still has the good intentions of the nice guy, but now he has the ability to say no and set boundaries like the bad boy. And as long as he doesn't go to this place where he's scared of getting into relationships and he just doesn't care about people and loses all his integrity, he will start moving towards that third stage man. When he cares most about being the most powerful version of a man he can be, he'll naturally start to become that guy. And that's what we teach here at Fearless. We start to help to teach you to become the best of these two worlds. A solid man for women, a solid man for you, a solid man for your future children, a solid man even if you're dating a lot of women, because you're real, you're honest, and women will become your biggest supporters, and it will improve your sex life immensely. So hopefully you like this video. And if you want to learn more about what it is to be a third stage man and go deeper into this topic, I'll be glad to create a video on it. Let a comment in the comments below. Or if you got questions or comments you want to say about this video in general, also comment in the video. I think we need to have more talks about what it is to be a third stage man. Go deeper into it, start to discuss this, and maybe I'll even bring in the other coaches and we'll have a deeper discussion of the development of this as men, because this is what the world really needs. Men of integrity, men of power, men that can set boundaries, men that can make shit happen, men that can say no, and men that can say yes because they want to, and they can go after their dreams because they want to. And women will be your biggest supporters. So again, comment in the video. I want to hear what you have to think about this. I want to hear if you want to know more about the third stage man and go deeper into it. I also want to encourage you that if you like the video, to make sure to subscribe to the channel, to like it, and to click that notification button to get it into your story feed. And remember, only the confident really live. See you in the next video.